Free John Wall. I've got my Rockets NBA Jam t-shirt. I want a Rockets one with John Wall on it. Welcome to Order on the Court. I'm Chris Mannix, joined by Howard Beck, and this is my opening argument. Well, Howard, I'm here to argue that the Houston Rockets need to play John Wall. Houston lost its 15th consecutive game on Monday in Boston, and Wall has not played a minute this season while the Rockets look to accommodate him with a trade. The Rockets are building something around Jalen Green, around Christian Wood, around Kevin Porter Jr., but John Wall would be an asset to this team. He would be useful on the floor to young guards like Porter Jr. and to Jalen Green. He would help prevent this team getting blown out in the same way they have on multiple occasions over the last couple of weeks. He's not going to make them a great team, but he will make them a slightly less embarrassing team, and he will do it while simultaneously perhaps boosting his trade value for a team that might be looking for a playmaker like him.
Well, Chris, allow me to retort. I think that John Wall at this stage of his career could be a potentially productive player, maybe for the Houston Rockets or maybe more likely somewhere else if any team wants to trade for a guy making $44 million this season and with an option to make $47 million the following season. This is not some problem that is easily resolved by put John Wall out on the court and suddenly the Rockets will be a little better and he'll be a better trade asset. The whole league knows what John Wall can and can't do. And in fact, he played last season and played decently well enough to put up some numbers, but not to change the trajectory of the Rockets then. He's not going to change their trajectory now either. John Wall is who he is at this stage, an older player who has gone through a lot of really tough injuries, making $44 million, a number that even if teams wanted to pay for, they'd have a hard time fitting it into their cap. This is a problem, frankly, without a solution. The Rockets don't have much use to play him. They're going young. John Wall can't really argue much about it. There's nothing for him to do to get out. I hate to invoke a favorite phrase of NBA players, but Chris, it kind of just is what it is.
Well, I mean, he can say, play me. I think he can do that. And the Rockets would have no choice but to put him into that rotation. I think John Wall should do that at some point. But equally as important in this argument, Howard, where is the NBA on this? Why is the league not stepping in and saying to the Rockets, if this guy is healthy, you've got to play him? The league effectively opened Pandora's box last year when they allowed Oklahoma City to shut down Al Horford for no other reason than the Thunder wanted to lose more games. The Rockets have taken that approach and taken it to a season-long level. They are effectively tanking from the start of this season to the end, and the league's saying it's okay. The league is effectively sanctioning the Rockets' tanking agenda.
I think that that is kind of the net effect. That's almost undeniable. But there's really no place for the NBA to be in this equation, Chris. They can't tell the Rockets who to play or how long to play them, how many minutes per game or how many games per week. It's not the league's place to tell any team how to manage its roster and rotation. So I'm sure that the league is cringing on a nightly basis watching the Rockets flail about going through what is barely even a stealth tank while John Wall, a still solid player, is sitting there in street clothes or sweats or whatever he may be wearing on a given night. It's not a great look, but there's no place for the league to act here. There's no authority and no real line to throw down because it's not their place to manage any team.
There's nothing stealthy about what the Rockets are doing this year. And at the very least, have to make up an injury. Remember plantar fascia? Let's go back to that and say John Wall is dealing with that. Howard, give me your closing argument.
Well, Chris, my closing argument is simply this. Occasionally, a team overspends, overpays a player. The Washington Wizards did that with John Wall, and then they offloaded him to the Houston Rockets for Russell Westbrook, and he became their problem. But that's their problem to deal with. And their problem right now is they're a team that is going young and rebuilding, and John Wall doesn't really make sense for them. So, sure, they could play him. Sure, the league could, I assume, maybe make some kind of threat to that they have to play him. It's not going to get anybody anywhere. John Wall will still be the same player with the same bad contract that no other team wants to acquire. And if anybody really wants to resolve this right now, the one person who has the power to do that would be John Wall. He could take a buyout and shave off 10 or 20 million and forego the option for next season at 47 million. I'm not by any means suggesting that John Wall should give up 40, 50, 60 million dollars. But if he wants out, if you want to resolve this tomorrow, that's the one foolproof way.
Hey, free John Wall. I've got my Rockets NBA Jam t-shirt. I've got Jalen Green. I've got Kevin Porter. I want a Rockets one with John Wall on it.